A big tree fell in the house.
Storms rolled through Baltimore County, leaving a trail of disaster.
Like a loud ba-boom noise. You could see things falling. Like in our backyard, some things fell, but didn't hit the cars or in the house.
I mean, it didn't last long. But it came through, you know, vicious. It was vicious.
Some neighbors out getting their first look at the damage.
Yes, extremely bad. You know, one of our neighbors, you know, as you can see, you know, just caught, you know, oh my goodness, it's crazy. Yeah, just the house is, you know, severely damaged.
On Sudvale Road, two homes were damaged by falling trees, taking out power lines. One now unlivable with a huge hole in the roof and major damage on the side where branches can be seen inside. Next door, another huge tree down, this one leaving less damage.
It didn't seem too windy in there. We pulled right into the garage and all of a sudden we heard a loud bang and we saw behind us in the driveway a bunch of twigs fall, and then my wife, who was in the house, my other two kids, who are 2 and 1, she came out yelling, like, get in the house.
Nick Boyle lives in Owings Mills and was a week away from putting his house on the market. His family now dealing with a massive cleanup after a tree fell on their roof. He says it was like a scene out of a movie.
It was like Jumanji in there. Like, so it went through and there's punctures. It went through the attic. But it didn't really, there was a couple things piercing the ceiling of our bedroom and stuff. And some water was trying to drip through on our bed.
Fortunately, no one was injured. His family riding out the rest of the storm in the basement. Today, they're still without power.
It was kind of scary, but like if you look at the overall picture, thankfully everyone's safe and everyone's out and everything can be fixed.